Thank you. Sedaj vas prosim, da vsi ponavljate za menoj.
Thank you. Namaste, Narasimha.
Najlepše pozdravljeni na tem našem velikem Hare Krishna festivalu. No, zelo sem počaščen in srečen, da vam lahko nocoj predstavim veliko mednarodno glasbeno spiritualno skupino Goranga Bhajan Band. Hvala. No, to je velika mednarodna skupina. No, zdaj bi pa želel povabiti konferencijera, to je Šila Šačinandana Sami, da pove nekaj več o nocojšnjem programu. Hvala lepa.
So, good evening. I'm very, very happy to announce to you this evening the Goranga Bhajan group in Ljubljana.
Dobro večer, zelo sem vesel, da lahko predstavim ta večer Goranga Bajan Band v Ljubljani.
I can remember that the people of Ljubljana always have been very enthusiastic to receive spiritual music and spiritual philosophy.
Spominjam se, da so ljudje v Ljubljani vedno doslej bili zelo entuzijastični, da sprejmejo spiritualno glasbo in spiritualno filozofijo.
With this program, we want you to come with us on a journey to spiritual India.
S tem programom vas želimo povabiti, da pridete z nami na potovanje po spiritualni Indiji.
A journey means an experience.
Potovanje pomeni izkušnja.
You hear something new.
Slišite nekaj novega?
You see something.
Vidite nekaj?
You understand something new.
Razumete nekaj novega?
And then you act and taste a new life.
Nakar izkusite in okusite novo življenje.
So, just like in this journey, where you experienced a new life, we want to let you experience first by hearing.
In tako kot na takšnem potovanju, kjer izkusite novo življenje, vam želimo dati izkušnjo, spiritualno izkušnjo najprej s poslušanjem.
It will be spiritual bhajan music, which will be the first part of our program.
To bo spiritualna bhajan glasba, ki bo prvi del našega programa.
In the second part, we want you to see something by the help of a multivision slideshow.
V drugem delu želimo, da vi nekaj vidite s pomočjo multivizijskega projekcije, showa.
And then we want you to understand something new. You will hear a lecture by a person who has traveled all over the world.
Potem si želimo, da razumete nekaj novega. Potem boste slišali predavanje od osebe, ki je potovala po celem svetu.
And finally, you will all become active.
Na koncu pa boste vsi postali aktivni.
Our last part of the program is called the mantra dance part, where we need all of you.
Naš zadnji del programa se imenuje Mantra Rock Ples, kjer bomo potrebovali vse vas.
The hope of this program is
upanje tega našega programa je
you take something new with you home.
Da se boj domov zamite nekaj novega.
A new experience which will actually give you some new kind of life.
Nova izkušnja, ki vam bo dejansko dala novo vrsto življenja.
Okay, so now this was the whole program. Now we will start with the musical part, the bhajan part.
To je bil cel program. Sedaj pa želimo začeti s prvim glasbenim programom, to so bhajani.
I want you to give a full applause to Goranga Bhajan Group.
Bye. Thank you. Vishnuvaraya, Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale, Srimate Bhakti Vedanta, Swami Niti Namine, Namaste Sarasvati Deve, Gauravani Pracharine, Nirvishesha Shunyavade, Paschatya Vishadharine. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
As I have said in the beginning of the program, it is like a journey this evening. We start with the ears, we go to the eyes, and now we go to the brain. We will hear some philosophy.
No, kot sem na začetku večera dejal, imamo danes spiritualno potovanje. Začeli smo z ušesi, potem z očmi, sedaj pa potrebujemo tudi naše možgane.
Our lecturer this evening is one of the pioneers here in Slovenia.
Predavatelj nocojšnji je eden izmed pionirjev tukaj v Sloveniji.
Spiritual pioneers.
Namreč spiritualnih pionirjev.
He came already as early as 1976 here and gave lectures.
Tukaj je prišel že tako rano, kot je 1976. Leta tukaj imel predavanja.
At that time it was not so easy. There was still the Tito dynasty ruling.
Tedaj ni bilo tako lahko, tedaj še vedno vladala dinastija Tita.
Our lecturer has traveled far and wide all over the world and he stays several months a year in India.
Naš predavatelj je prepotoval v svet večkrat in vsako leto več mesece preživi v Indiji.
At the present time he is writing on a book which will be giving some details of spiritual practice.
No, v tem trenutku on piše knjigo, ki bo povedala mnogo detajlov o spiritualni praksi.
I want to request you to give a full applause to Krishna Chetra Prabhu. Thank you very much. You're a very enthusiastic audience.
Najlepša hvala, ste zelo entuziastična publika.
Are you all having a good time?
Yes.
Ali se dobro zabavate?
So that is our success.
To je vedno uspeh.
So you have just seen this multivision about reincarnation. You have heard some transcendental music.
Ravno kar smo videli to multivizijo o reinkarnaciji, slišali nekaj transcendentalne glasbe.
You saw this Arctic greeting ceremony for Gorni Thai.
Videli ste Arctic, ceremonija pozdrava Gorni Thaiju.
So, how do all of these things connect? This we want to try to explain for a few minutes.
No, sedaj kako lahko povežemo te različne stvari, to bom sedaj poskusil razložiti v nekaj naslednjih minutah.
I know what you need.
Vem, kaj potrebuješ.
You need a lady fish.
Potrebuješ ribo damo.
In this way the poor fish, Igor the fish, finally died.
In ta način je ta naš ubogi Igor riba končno umrl.
Yeah, it's a sad story.
Da, zgodba je žalostna.
And actually our story in this material world is also sad.
In dejansko je naša zgodba v tem materialnem svetu tudi žalostna.
And this is actually what is being explained by this reincarnation show.
In to je ravno tisto, kar je pravzaprav razložil ta show oziroma predstava reinkarnacije.
As long as we don't recognize what it is that we actually need.
Tako dolgo, dokler ne uvidimo, kaj je tisto, kar v resnici potrebujemo,
all of our attempts to become satisfied in this world will be frustrated.
Bodo vsi naši poskusi, da postanemo zadovoljni tem svetu, frustrirani.
And the result of that is that we take birth. So, there are many different planets, higher and lower.
Obstajajo torej mnogi različni planeti, višji in nižji.
Some are very heavenly, some are very hellish.
Nekateri so zelo rajski, drugi zelo peklenski.
Now, depending on how we act, and therefore how our consciousness develops in this life, That determines what our next residence will be.
In sedaj odvisno od tega, kako mi delujemo in kakšno je naše stanje zavesti v tem življenju, to odloča, kakšno bo naše naslednje življenje.
Maybe we'll take birth again in Ljubljana.
In kje se bomo rodili? Morda se bomo znova rodili v Ljubljani.
Very nice.
To je zelo lepo.
Ah, but will we take birth in Ljubljana as a human being?
Toda, ali se bomo rodili v Ljubljani kot človek?
If one lives a life in a very degraded way, doing very degraded activities, that will lower the consciousness.
Če kdo živi življenje, zelo degradirano življenje, in počne zelo degradirane aktivnosti, bo to znižalo z njegovo zavest.
And then depending where the consciousness is focused, at the time of death,
in odvisno od tega, kam je ta zavest osredotočena v trenutku smrti,
that will determine what the next life will be and where it will be.
To bo odločilo, kakšno bo naslednje življenje in kje bo to življenje.
So all of this is working by what is called the law of karma.
Vse to funkcionira po tako imenovanem zakonu karme.
Karma works something like a bank account.
Karma je nekaj podobnega kot bančni račun.
You can put money into the bank and save it.
Vi lahko vložite denar v banko in ga hranite.
Similarly, you can act in a certain way to get some credit for the future.
In na podoben način lahko delujete na takšen način, da boste imeli kredit, obresti za prihodnost.
But if you spend that bank account, you end up with nothing, then you may become a beggar.
Če pa potrošite bančni račun, potem lahko postanete berač.
So, Bhagavad Gita says, Abrahma Bhuvanaloka Puna Arbartino Arjuna, from the topmost planet in this universe down to the lowest, all are places of suffering.
Bhagavad Gita pravi, da vse od najvišjega planeta v tem univerzumu, pa vse do najnižjega, so vsa mesta trpljenja.
Why so? Thank you very much. Now we come to the last point of our program, the mantra dance, we call it.
Najlepša hvala. Sedaj smo prišli do zadnjega dela našega programa, katerega imenujemo mantra rock ples.
You all know how to sing along nicely.
Tako da mislim, da treba povaljamo v rango vašega zelo tehnole, da najboljši dobili se najmanj malo vaje, tako da bomo lahko zelo lepo skupaj sledi.
Are you ready?
Very good, but you have to sing louder.
On the bass guitar.
Na bass gitari.
On the keyboard.
Na klaviatura.
Directly from Germany.
Direkt aus Deutschland.
From the Berkeley, Berkeley.
Yes, Berkeley, yeah.
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles. No, Los Angeles. Sorry.
Did you come up with the Then directly from the sunny Italy.
But then never say the songs in Italia.
Then directly from down south somewhere.
But then never say the dog. You work in a Lugo. Okay.
It is on the Rolling Thunder. He comes from South Italy.
The Roman Yoshi Grom, the highest usual Italian.
Madonna. Then a devotee who has traveled far and wide, who has given the lecture to all of you, a very transcendental personality, not often seen on the stage.
To pobachta, ki bi dal ves svet in ki dal tudi predavanje in ki ga redko kole vidimo na odru.
Krishna Chandra Babu! Thank you.
Then, last but not least,
me.
Potem pa zadnji, tudi ne, nazaj.
A great transcendental personality.
Velika transcendentalna osebnost.
Who is sometimes in Romania,
ki včasih v Romuniji,
sometimes in Czechoslovakia,
včasih v Češoslovaški,
sometimes in Iceland and Greenland,
včasih na Islandiji, v Grenlandiji,
inspiring everyone with his lectures and personality,
inspiriral vsakogar s svojimi predavanji in osebnostjo. Na zadnje, tudi ne na zadnje.
Not from this world.
Ni iz tega sveta.
Whose feet never touch the ground.
Čigar stopala, ki nikoli ne zdahnejo tal. Doranga Bašan Benda, bodo jutri znova z nami v festivali Kvarane ob 16. Ne zamudite!
Namah.
to hear that.
No!
But please, let us hear it by hearing you chant.
Ma prosto, dovrate si svede che stiamo dove vi poete.
Hare Krishna!
Thank you. Guitar and bass. But now we chant a very simple melody that everybody can follow. Translated Kijai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Thank you. Om Gyanatam Nandasya Yanandana Sharakaya Chakshuram Nidatam Yena Tasmahe Shri Gurave Shri Chaitanya Namo Vishtam Shtavitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rugubira Mahyam Dharati Svavarantikam Vancha Kapatruvyascha Kripa Sindhuvyevacha Patitanam Pavaneyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
While at our festival program last night, I still see people here is the festival. Somebody wasn't there.
Are you going to
share it? He missed something.
Someone didn't.
So, you all have this appreciation of Krishna consciousness, I think, to a great degree. It is not an artificial imposition on the mind.
Svest Krishna ni neka umetna, kar bi bilo treba prisiliti naš um, da to misli.
And the effect, the result of being Krishna conscious is that one is naturally happy.
Učinek ali rezultat tega, da je kdo zavestno Krishna, pa je, da je naravno srečen.
This natural happiness is something which we don't appreciate much in our culture these days.
Ta naravna sreča je nekaj, kar v tej naši kulturi dan današnjem času ne cenimo ravno preveč.
Okay.
Ali vsi vete to besedo? Bahta, kaj pomeni?
Who doesn't know this?
Kdo ne vete besede? Pomena?
Bahta means one who is actively serving Krishna in devotion.
Bhakta, to je oseba, ki aktivno služi Krišni v z vedanostjo, bila umetno srečo.
A lot of people are bewildered when they see bhaktas.
Mnogi ljudje so zmedeni, kadar vidijo bhakte.
What is this which motivates you to chant Hare Krishna?
Kaj je to, kar vas motivira, da pojete Hare Krishna?
And what is it that makes you give up so many activities which people think are so essential to life?
In kaj je tisto, zaradi česar ste se odrekli mnogim stvarem, za katere ljudje mislijo, da so nekaj bistvenega v življenju?
And because they don't understand, they often come to a false conclusion of their own making, that somehow a devotee must be a little bit crazy.
In ker ne razumejo, potem na nek način pridejo do svojega lastnega zaključka, ki je, da ti bhakte morajo biti na nek način nori.
Nori? Say that devotees are brainwashed.
Včasih tudi pravijo, da imajo bhakte oprane možgane.
They're always smiling. Someone who is always smiling must be something wrong with it.
Seveda smihajo, to je seveda na smiha, gotovo je nekaj narobe z njim.
Because it's a foregone conclusion, it's a basic assumption that there must be a mixture of happiness and distress. And just like a deep body of water, in the depths of that water, the fish, they are not affected by what is happening on the surface.
Tako kot v zelo globokem vodnem zbiralniku, ribe, ki živijo globoko na dnu, niso sploh vznemirjene zaradi vznemirjen, ki se dogaja na površini te vode.
Another description of such a person is here in Bhagavad Gita. He is called Prasannatma, one who is very, very joyful, Prasanna.
Imenuje se Prasannatma, oseba, ki je zelo radostna.
So I wanted to explain the very famous teaching. Maybe some of you have already heard this teaching of the great sage Rishabhdev in Vedic times, and he had no less than 100 sons.
Rishabhdev bil kralj v vedskem času in imel nič manj kot 100 sinov.
And as he became aged, he decided to give up his kingdom and go to the forest to become absorbed in Krishna consciousness.
No, in ko je ostarel, se odločil, da zapusti svoje kraljestvo in da odide v gozd ter se posveti popolnoma zavesti Krišne.
This was very common in Vedic times that kings would do this.
V vedskih časih je bilo to nekaj običajnega, kralji so to počeli.
Before he left for the forest, he left some instructions with his sons.
Preden pa šel v gost, je svojim sinovom pustil navodila.
And one of these instructions is very famous.
In ena izmed teh navodil je zelo slavna.
Nayan deha devo bhajan roke kashan kama arhate vidvijani tako divyam putra gayena sattvam shupyat tasma yashma ramsotyam tanantam. He's talking about what they should do and what they should not do.
On tukaj govori, kaj naj bi oni počeli in če se ne bi smeli početi.
And his instructions, of course, are valuable not just for his sons, but for all of us.
Jasno, njegova navodila niso dragocena samo za njegove sinove, ampak za vse nas.
He says, first of all, don't live like dogs and the dogs.
Na prvem mestu pravi, da ne živite kot psi in svinje.
Who are simply interested in eating and sex.
Ki se preprosto zanimajo samo za jedenje in za seks.
And who are not discriminating what they eat or who they have sex with.
In ki ne delajo nobene razlike, kaj jedo in s kom imajo seks.
Don't be, you are a human being and therefore you should act as a human being.
Vi ste človeška bitja in zato morate tudi delovati kot ljudje.
It is unfortunate that this essential instruction is not commonly known in our society today.
To je nesrečno, da to navodilo ni nasplošno znano v današnji družbi.
It is in fact a great pity and also a cause of great unhappiness even for the devotees that people don't know this basic point.
To je zelo obžalovanje vredno. In pravzaprav nesrečna okoliščina tudi za bahte, namreč da ljudje ne poznajo te poante.
This most basic point that we should act as human beings, not as animals.
Te najbolj bazične poante namreč, da naj ne bi živeli kot živali, ampak kot ljudje.
So what does that mean? Rishabhdev answers.
In kaj to pomeni? Rishabhdeva odgovarja.
Tapo divya putra gayena sattvam. We should, as human beings, be prepared to perform what is called tapasya.
Kot človeška bitja bi morali biti pripravljeni, da izvajamo tako imenovano tapasya.
This word tapasya means basically austerity.
Ta beseda, tapasya, v osnovi pomeni strogost.
But, he says, tapo divyam, not any kind of austerity, but transcendental austerity, this you should perform.
Vendar pa nekaterakoli vrste strogosti ali askeze, temveč transcendentalno strogost moramo izvajati. Oni trenirajo.
Taking on various difficulties in order to accomplish something.
In nas spremljajo vse mogoče težave, da bi pač napredovali.
Some goal they have in mind. Usually something related to fame, profit and distinction.
V umu imajo nek cilj, v glavnem povezan z slavo, z ugledom in profitom.
Slavo, z ugledom, ne, profitom.
Bravo. Jaz smo zato tudi pojede z nami.
They can eat through the mouth and shout through the nose.
Can try to do that.
That's real
yoga.
Lahko jedo skozi usta in poja skozi ušesa, to je yoga.
So what was the thing that you liked most yesterday?
Difficult question. You didn't like anything.
A kaj ste najraši, kaj je bilo najlepše včeraj?
Maha mantra.
Maha mantra. That's nice, very nice. Yes. Maha mantra? Oh, yes. Yeah, because you notice the songs, we all played so many different songs, but basically the words, they all are the same, it's always the Maha Mantra. I'm sure that you never thought that we could have so many different melodies. It would be nice to have someone who, local persons who can sing the Maha Mantra just right here now with a Slovenian.
Can we go down the line until turn it off so we can go away?